So without further ado, let me start my session. Mm-hmm. So this is about a very interesting thing. This is about ease in detection using Azure customization services. So let's jump in and I'll give the motivation behind it. So what is the motivation of doing this? We might know that every third byte of food realizable pollination, but honeyhive bee losses are quite prevalent in disease. But the indication of hive strength, what is the health of the bees, is very time consuming and disruptive to the bees' workflow and hive in general. So by investigating the bees that leave the hive, we gain a more complete understanding of the hive itself. For example, an unhealthy hive infected with varroa mites, we have these deformed wings or mites on the mites. These characteristics can be observed without opening the hive. So that is the motivation. So it is an ecological problem and we are trying to solve it through image classification. So what are we trying to do? We are aiming to detect healthy and various types of disease genes and disease and problems, the varroa and hive digits with the help of Azure computer vision services. So where do I find the data? The data, what we have done is that I have taken a data set which is from Tagged, and I'll make a very small data set. So these are the links that are there, and we can go into the Tagged link as well. If you just use this. So if I go into this, so this is the actual data set. It is quite large. It is around 54.74 MB. But what I have done is that I've gone ahead and made the data set, which is a subset of that. It is all in Tagged, it is free, so you can download it and see it. So intention is to detect healthy and various types of disease. So what are the steps? So I'll just give you the steps here and then we walk through the example and how we have done. So first is we create a custom vision resource. And then we create a custom vision AI project, and then we add images to the project, and we train on the images and create a model. So these are only factual things. What we will do is that we'll go into the Azure and we'll see. So this is the, we are in customvision.ai. So I have already done the project myself because training takes a lot of time. If you are going to do it yourself, so that's actually very easy. Can you create project? You can say bees. Since I've got a bees project, maybe bees two. Bees add some description, and you create the resource. So here you can create one resource, whatever resource you want. You can create a resource. You can choose your subscription. You can choose your resource group. This is cognitive services, it's a location and a pricing. So this is how you would create a resource. And then what you would do is that you choose a project type, whether it's a classification or an object detection. So in this case, since we are classifying the bees, we should be choosing classification and not object detection. Here, we will be choosing the classification type. So you can go here and see what is the meaning of it. But basically what it means is that for one image, there is only a single layer. It is not a multi-level problem. Meaning, if it is an ant problem, having some ant problems, then it is an image of ant problems. If it is an image of, say, varroa hive bites, then it is an image of ant problems. If it is healthy, it is healthy. So it is a single tag per image. And there are certain domains here, we make it general, and then we can create a project. I will not do it because I have already done this project, and so this project out here. So what are we doing is that then what we do is that we add images. So how we add images, I have already added the images, but I'll show you of how you can add images. You can add these images by say going to add images. You can go to here, maybe say suppose I'm doing healthy and problems. So I'll choose here, I'll say open, and then what I'll do is that I'll add new tag. So here I'm choosing the images and I'm putting a tag, and then I'll upload the images. So what would happen? You see here I've already done this because the training and the uploading takes time. So I have and problems, which is I've all these keys that I have uploaded out. Similarly, I have uploaded some healthy bees. So these are the healthy bees which are down here. Similarly, I have narrow hive beetles which are here. So it is a three class problem. So there are three types of labels here. And after I have done, what I do is that I go ahead and train. So training, I can choose quick training. So this trains the image and it takes a lot of time. So I've already done it. So it's already trained. So the training, what will happen is that, so as Simon was saying, so this is a great thing. So previously, if you were a researcher or a deep learning data scientist, what would happen is that you have to write all these algorithms, all these models like ResNet, efficient net and all these complicated models. You don't understand the structure, but here you do not need to do anything. Just you have to know your domain. So the domain here was these. You have to know the label. Somebody will label it for you. So if you're a domain expert, this is great. So it helps you that once you label it properly, so now it is these that we are talking. You can talk about more serious problem like, say suppose if you're in a manufacturing industry or an utilities industry, you will have some, say, rods or assets where there are some cracks. You can do these type of things. You can label it somewhere with some crack type 1, crack type 2, crack type 3, and you can differentiate between them. So that becomes very easy. So for a domain expert, it's a great thing that you see. And then you train it. Once you train it, it's already trained. And then you can do quick test. So what would happen is that after it has trained, you use this model so that you can use it for training, for testing. So what I do is that I browse to a local file out here. So here I have, so suppose I test it. So I choose this image and I go here and I see the tags which is coming up. So it says that it's a narrow hive beetle and it's a healthy and ant problem. So actually it's giving that this one is the one, it's a narrow hive beetle. But to know whether we have done it correctly or not, so what we'll do is that we'll see the actual data. So what did we choose? We chose this guy, so it is 040314. So I have the data actually with me from the data set 040314. So if I just do a filter, 040314. Okay. So it is a narrow hive. So it is giving like this narrow hive beetle. So this is the one. So it is doing it by. So we will see of how we can do. So this is from the E1. So what would happen if I try to use it in a program? So what would happen is that this is a project out here. And then what I will do is that I will go to the project. And there is a project ID out here. So this is important. And this is the project ID is important, the key is important, and endpoint is important. Now, once I have trained, so say suppose Now, you have spent a lot of time in labeling and training the model. Now, what you do is that you want to use it in your own application. So, what I did was that I am using this endpoint, which is there, and the key, and I am using the project ID as an API in an external program. So, what I did was that I went around and created an application, a Node.js app. So here, there is a blog also I've written for this. I'll share all these links with you. So here, what I've done is that I've created a Node application. So this Node application I've created, and it is installing, we will install all these libraries, the cognitive services, custom vision training, the cognitive services, custom vision prediction. And then we import these libraries. And then we have the training API, the prediction of the end. And then we have the root where the data is kept. We have the prediction key, endpoint, the iteration name, and the project ID. Note what is important, prediction key, endpoint, and the project ID. Otherwise, all these things are all standard things, but what will be unique is this. So this is required for predicting and for authentication. So once, and you can get all these things from your project. So project ID, key, and endpoint. So I went around and did all these things. All the code is here. So then what I do is that I pass on an image like 040314. Or I can pass in 030471 also. 430471 030. And what would happen is that I'm going to use this for predicting. So if you see, these things are for prediction. And this is the data that I am passing in, and I am using it for predicting. And then I am using it as to calculate the probability. So if I just run it, so if I say this, so it is giving AND problems. So this thing over here, 030471, it is having AND problems. Let's see whether we have done it correctly. If I go into this file, 030471. You see, it is AND problems. So I have predicted it correctly. It is showing me AND problems here. So this is how, in a very simple way, if you're a domain expert, you can train it, and then you can give it to the developers. And if you're a developer, also you can do it. If you have some amount of domain knowledge for labeling and for doing all these things. So it is very, very seamless and easy to solve very complex problems and to solve very problems that is affecting the world with your custom vision service. So that was the whole intention.